When the peach cobbler was so good, you had to return.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm so excited because we're heading to Georgia.
Yep, again.
Again. Yeah, it's been, what, 4 or 5 years that we visited. So prior to 2020, COVID, everything, it was like a little tradition we had. Every year we would take a weekend vacation to Georgia, and we would love to go to Savannah. We'll visit Atlanta occasionally, but Savannah was like our chill go-to spot to visit, right? And so we haven't been since 2019, so I'm looking forward to going back. But we're not just going back to go back, we're also celebrating our 9-year wedding anniversary, so I'm super excited about that. We're on the road and we're not sure about exactly what we're gonna do, but we're gonna do some stuff. And
we'll tell you what we didn't decide to do. So it was either we were trying to decide through a couple things that we wanted to do. Let me tell you how it went down. First, we were looking at possibly going to Las Vegas. Las Vegas, we've never been. You know, it'd be a plane ride, you know, go to somewhere else. But then, for some reason, the hotels we were looking at, they were all dingy.
Dingy. I was like, no. I'm not picky, but no.
And the beds looked itchy.
And the reviews were horrible.
The reviews are horrible. I was like, we were finding some good prices. We were finding like resorts for like $23 a night. I'm like,
but that says a lot. And you know, we're not big, and you know, I know there's more to do in Vegas than just casinos, smoking and drinking, but we're not about that life. So it was hard for us to really justify a trip to Vegas.
Yeah, but it looked cool. I mean, like even the place that you were trying to stay at, it looked like a medieval castle. You know, I'm all about that. So I'm like,
it's
all right.
Super cool.
But then, you know, my instincts kick in. And I'm like, all right, let me, $23 a night and it looks just extravagant. What's wrong with it? You know, that's my first doubt. The reviews. And then I'm like, I'm seeing posts of people posting live videos of cockroaches running all over the floor. People saying that the air, that when they're, it's very musty and moldy smelling, the air, like it's very old, and for me that is huge. The next thing we were looking at possibly going to Texas. Found good flights there. The flight was only like $120 to go there.
It's not bad at all.
But then asked me how much it was to carry luggage.
Carry luggage was like more than what it cost to fly there. I was like, this is ridiculous. And then while I could find a bunch of places to visit online, I still wasn't too excited about it. Neither was Shane.
And then the third option that I was considering was possibly going on a cruise.
And I'm all about cruises.
But Narayda didn't want to go on a cruise because she was watching the news. And
the week that we were thinking of going to a cruise, there was a horrible situation happening with Carnival. I'm not going to get into it, but it was just sketchy. We are in hurricane season and I'm not ready to take any risk. So that was it.
Think about cruises, especially during this time of the year. If, say, you're on your way to Mexico, right? And all the way to Mexico, a tropical storm develops in the Atlantic or the Gulf.
You're basically screwed.
You're screwed because
you're stuck there.
What they're going to do, they're going to divert the storm and you're gonna miss your port of call, and they're not gonna refund you for that. So basically you're paying for the ship to carry you to locations, and they can just erase a location or two if there's a
storm. Remember that one time that something happened in the cruise and we didn't get to go to, where was it, Mexico?
Yes,
just because
exactly
someone had an emergency on the in the ship. So it was like a life or death thing. So of course I understand. If it was my family member, I would want the ship to stop too. But we didn't get to go to one of our port of calls because that's how you say it, right? Port of call. Port of calls because of that. And there's nothing you can do. You can't get refunded. That's part of the contract you signed. So long story short, now we're here. So why Georgia? These are the reasons.
The food is good.
The food is good. We enjoy walking through Forsyth Park. We enjoy downtown. We love the historic district. It's so chill, so relaxing. And we get to see different hotels or Airbnbs this time. We're staying at an Airbnb. It's far. It's distant, but it's still close enough to everything we want to do. So it's not too bad. Oh, it's so just scenic. It's the scenic view for me. It's the peace. It's the getting away from the same old that I see here in Florida. Because if not, it was going to be us going back to St. Petersburg, Sarasota, Tampa, or Miami, which I definitely don't mind. But we do that like every year. So anyways, if it's your first time at Georgia, if you've never been to Savannah, Georgia before, tag along. Thank you so much, you guys, for watching. You may have seen a bunch of other videos about Georgia, but you may see something different here. So go ahead, hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to click the notification bell so that you know when we post another video.
See you guys when we get there. We'll tag you along and you'll see the places that we go.
Alright, who's hungry? We're gonna have some road snacks.
Okay.
So this time around, this is what we're working with, okay? This is a tip, guys. You pre-planned this, okay? So we have our lunchbox here, okay? I'm gonna turn around the camera. Hold on. Okay. So up top we have some Rice Krispies, protein bars, and Stroop wafers, okay? This is just part one. Okay. But here we have some pre-frozen water bottles. We have birthday cake Kit Kat. We're about to try this. This is our first time trying this one. I remember trying the coffee one's pretty good. It was a hit. The regular one, of course. White chocolate one, of course. Birthday cake, let's see. And then we had some pre-cold, pre-frozen bottled waters. Keeps everything cold, but to keep things colder longer, we had this gel ice pack. It's clutch, especially for traveling. And then down below, we have some coconut water. Yes, baby. And then on the way here, like when we left, we had my homemade cucumber coconut water, which was super hydrating. We knew it was gonna be hot. I'm like, baby, before we leave, I'm gonna prep this natural juice for us so that we're hydrated in the sun, no one's burning up on our way to Georgia. But we're about to try this Kit Kat. I'm super excited about this. Okay, and also, wait, I almost forgot. We have racetrack chips. I don't know why, babe, why do you love these so much? Shaheen loves these. Oh no, these are mine, cheddar and sour cream. But I'm gonna share with him, of course. But Shaheen's hooked on these barbecue racetrack
flavoring on those chips.
Hands down. Hands down.
And then the texture, the chip isn't greasy, it's kettle cooked. But that with the barbecue sauce that they use, I'll admit, like sometimes when we're buying it, like the person that was working in the factory that day sucked. But the one time when you get it with the person that applies enough of the seasoning to the chip, oh man, it's done.
It's so good. Guys, these come through. These hit different. Okay, I love these. And then we got the cheddar ones. And of course, couldn't miss the grandma cookies. But there's some so loud somewhere in here. I would have done like Snickers, Twix, candies, but I'm trying to not have so much sugar. I can't really have a lot of sugar. I love Lay's chips. I love nachos and oh, forget it. But this time around, this is what we're working with. I'm hungry. We have, how long we got left? Let's check this GPS. We have an hour and 38 minutes out of 4.5 hours, 4 hours and 40 minutes really, of traveling. We'll be there soon. I'm super excited. What's your favorite snack when you're on a road trip or just traveling? What are you working with? Share that, comment below. Don't be like that, okay? Come on, comment below. Anything you wanna say?
4 miles till the Georgia, Florida state line.
Yes! Awesome, I gotta get that shot.
5 minutes.
So we finally arrived to Savannah, Georgia. We are in Calhoun Square near Chippewa Square, only a few blocks from Forsyth Park. Did you know that this is where Forrest Gump was filmed? Yes, like literally was actually filmed here. We're walking through those beautiful squares
And while we're heading to our lunch destination, we've been on the road for near 4.5 hours and we are starving. There's so many places to eat nearby. There's a lot of restaurants. But one of our go-to spots, which you'll see in just a moment, is the Tequila Mexican restaurant. And, well, it's been a few years, so I hope it's as good as we remember it. This is our general Savannah vlog, but check out our anniversary vlog, which will highlight other areas that we enjoyed, such as Forsyth Park, in about 2 days. But enjoy this video and don't forget to subscribe. Here we go. Now, we arrived at the Tequila Town Mexican restaurant. This place is so good. It's not crazy expensive, but it's not cheap. Like, it's inexpensive, and it's good quality food, good serving, good service. Like, it's a go-to. Like, it's a must. While we were here, we also met other tourists, like people that were strolling through Savannah for work. So this is what we got. Shaheen got fish tacos. I got their shrimp avocado burrito with rice. Guys, it hits. It's so good. Then later on in the evening, we went to Savannah's peach cobbler. This is a spot. Did you know Georgia's national fruit is peach? So this is a peach cobbler spot and we had to try it.
What you trying there?
It's called a praline crunch. Peach. Caramel crunch, something.
So guys, we're here in downtown Savannah and we found a place called the Peach Cobbler Factory. As you know, peaches is their fruit. They're known for it, but this is the spot. So we're gonna try this, what was it? The praline peach cobbler. It's so warm. I wish you guys could smell it right now. The cup feels warm, it smells delicious, and we're gonna have it with some ice cream. What type of ice cream is this?
Vanilla.
The feels are great here. We're about to try this for the first time. Over here. Hold on. I wish you guys were here to try this.
You're gonna get the first bite.
Am I?
How many offered them if they want a picture?
Oh yeah. Oh, I could take it. Yeah. Okay.
All right. Here you go.
Ooh.
First bite.
For me? He just went with the fork.
Yeah,
you're
so
sweet. You need to try that.
Is it good?
I got you now.
Don't get the peachy part.
I put peachy part in there. Payback. There you go. I love you. Enjoy. How is it?
Wow.
I told you. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you feeling today, babe?
I'm good.
Good?
I'm rested.
Awesome. So there were some deers over here yesterday. They come like every day. And what were the birds, Shaheen?
Hummingbirds.
Hummingbirds. Oh, they were so cute. I'm gonna capture some clips and show you guys later. How do you feel, babe?
Feel good. It's a new day.
tomorrow is our wedding anniversary. Isn't that crazy? 9 years already? Yeah. And the sun is hitting me pretty hard, so I'm looking like a ghost when I do this. Yes. We want to pass by a nursery. Like I said, I don't know if you guys heard, but we're in Port Winsworth. It's here in Savannah, and it's so beautiful. It's so nature-esque. It's like... There's Cutie Patootie over here. We just had some. Let me unzoom myself. All right, so brief correction, guys. I stand corrected. We're not in downtown. We were in downtown yesterday. Right now, we are in the City Market in Savannah. And that is where Little Duck Diner is, where we went for brunch. Highly recommend. In this area, there's boat tours. In this area, there's trolley tours, horse carriage rides, and there's awesome Savannah Candy Kitchen. I remember the first time that we were here, we went in here, you got free praline samples. They're known for their candy, their pralines. It is so yummy. It's so warm and fresh in there. And then they also have great ice cream. Riverwalk has the gelato, and that's where we're heading right now. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Cheers. So good. So there's multiple Savannah candy shops, and this one in particular has the train going all around their candy shop. And then they have another section of different types of candy. So in the beginning, it's more of like praline, the praline factory, and then you see the candy shop in the back that's more like fruity candies, but there's a variety of things. There's even stuff for dogs, there's shopping areas, there's trolley rides, horse carriage rides. Guys, it's so worth it. So Shane wanted to check out some souvenirs here. We didn't do the trolley this time just because we're a little bit more familiar with the area and we just wanted to walk and do a few things, but now we're in Riverfront. We are in Savannah's Riverfront. There's boats, as you see here, a lot of cobblestone streets. It looks easier than what it is to walk here.
Then we went to another Savannah candy kitchen that they have. I told you they have multiple spots. This one has a canned ice cream shop inside of it. So we enjoyed some ice cream. Guys, it was ridiculously hot, so we had to take a break with their nice cold ice cream and sit out at the Riverwalk for a while. Just watch the river, talk, chat for a while we ate our ice cream because it was just too hot. And there was a nice cool breeze by the river, thankfully. Now, there are some old historic tracks in these cobblestone streets, as you see here. I like that Savannah has preserved a lot of its history. That's why the roads look like this. And there's no history back here where you can bring the what you can imagine. The Lover's Bridge is also nearby. And yeah, a lot of good spots. There's also a really nice the M French Cafe here, which is really good. Now, when you see me walking up down this strip, this is the second half of the Riverwalk strip. We walked all the way down here. But we did this time, and it's basically that, like, shops and restaurants going all the way down the Riverwalk. So it's the river, there's boats, cobblestone streets, and on the other side of that whole walk is shops and restaurants. You could spend a good afternoon, evening here, but trust us, in the summertime, Savannah is very hot, just like Florida. It was almost 100 degrees today. It was 99 degrees. It was so hot. So I don't know how we did it, but we did. It was like the 97, but feels like 99. Yeah. Now, this is an old church bell. A lot of old monuments and historic sightings and doing some history. The Lover's Bridge is near here as well. We like to just see history and especially areas that are historic, like Savannah, it's one of the oldest towns. It's neat. Down here, there's more shopping. Look at the Spanish mosque. Savannah's full of the beautiful Spanish mosque. The French Cafe is behind here. Up forward, you see the Lover's Bridge. Now, there was some construction going on under it, so it didn't look as nice as we remember when we came like a few falls ago. But it's a lock bridge. That's why I call it Lover's Bridge. It's a lock bridge. If you go toward, you go there, you could bring a lock or purchase one in a nearby shop, and you and your partner can write your initials, and it's cute and romantic. We're back in Sweet Potatoes after how many years? But this was our once a year tradition. How do you feel being back?
Feels like our restaurant, our spot.
Our spot, yeah. And what's your favorite thing here? Which we all know by now.
Banana pudding.
Yes. So supposedly it is the best. It tastes the best. It is the best. I gotta say, it's with the best banana pudding. They were on Food Network and they've got a bunch of rewards for it. And this is a go-to spot in Savannah, Georgia. It's called Sweet Potatoes. And this is what we got. Hey guys, so they earned the world's best banana pudding by Man vs. Food online. Look it up. Sweet Potatoes, banana pudding, hands down, one of the best. Shaheen argues that it is the best in the world.
It is the best in the world.
He hasn't, you know, really tried my mom's banana pudding, but okay. So the foodie is pretty good. I got the fried shrimp with sweet potato fries and some roasted Brussels sprouts. Shaheen got liver and their banana pudding. It did look different from what we're used to, but it was still good. We tried that towards the end. Walking around here. This is where Forrest Gump was filmed, guys. Isn't that cool? I found that pretty interesting. Walking on more history, people. This is such a lovely place to be. Oh my gosh, it's just the feels are so different. It's even nicer during the fall.
Hey guys, we're here in Forsyth Park and we're celebrating our 9-year anniversary. Oh, yeah.
guys, we're at Betty Bombers in Savannah, Georgia. It's just a few, like less than a few steps from the Forsyth Park. We're so close, and we're in the parking lot putting the address on the GPS, and it's like, it's just a few feet away from you. Like, we're gonna walk there, and this place does not disappoint. It's historic. It's an actual post, right, babe? That's what you told me. Yeah, it's an actual post. There's a lot of like war history here. We love it. And the food is delicious. So I got the cheesesteak, and baby, what you got?
Fish tacos.
Yeah, we got the fish tacos. It was actually a recommendation of our Airbnb host. Shout out to you, Paul. And yeah, guys, if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up and hit that notification bell. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more on travel, faith, family, and challenges, all things. Stay well, be blessed, and continue to live the fine life. Good morning, everyone.
Hey, guys, what's up?
This is our... Unfortunately, this is our last day here in Savannah, Georgia. We're outside of our lovely Airbnb where we stood. And I'm gonna share this screenshot showing you where you can access the same Airbnb that we stood at here in Savannah, Georgia.
That's right. It's a beautiful location. Here, it's like you're somewhere else. And this property specifically, there's just so much to see and experience.
Yeah. We really enjoyed our host, both Paul and Carrie. Shout out to you guys. You guys are amazing. They're so friendly. We love them. We gotta say they're one of the best hosts we've ever had.
Number one.
Yeah. So Paul and Carrie are very friendly. We had lovely conversations with them. They truly know how to host a location. They made us feel right at home, and we enjoyed also spending some time outside. We're currently outside in their deck, right? That'd be the right term for it, in their deck, where we're able to see the hummingbirds. So many hummingbirds. I've never seen so many hummingbirds in my life, because we don't really get them like that often in Florida.
They're there, but they're just rare.
Yeah, it's rare. And deers. So that's another strange thing. We don't really see deer like that where we're from. So the fact that deers were coming out and near the balcony like every single day is super cool. So if you're into nature and you want to have a enjoyable experience in Savannah, Georgia, we definitely recommend stay with Paul, okay? Meet Paul and Carrie. They're amazing. I'm putting the instructions on where you can find their Airbnb here on the side of the screen. So go ahead and check them out. You won't regret it. It's also very close to everything. This location was about 15 minutes from all the main parts. For example, Forsyth Park, downtown Savannah, the city market?
Yeah, downtown, yeah. Or Riverwalk.
And Riverwalk, yeah. So it was close by to everything. We had such a great stay. We hadn't even left yet, and we're already thinking of coming back. We're returning. That's how amazing it is. So guys, if you're looking for a place to stay in Savannah, don't think twice. Just click accept and book it. Just book it and come visit. So huge shout out to Paul and Carrie. You guys are amazing. We thank you so much for your hospitality.
That was great.
For your how friendly you are.
Great conversations.
And you guys are great. So thank you so much. I really recommend it. Stay here. Visit Savannah, Georgia. There's so much to do. It's a historic district. And yeah, and really good food too. So
that's right.
Guys, if you're new here, we want to welcome you to hit that subscribe button. Click that notification bell so that you know when we post another video, and give this video a big thumbs up.
So another cool thing about this day is that there is technically no checkout time. Our host Paul, he's very flexible about the time that you check out, that you can ease your way, into your upcoming drive back or your stay, at no stress. So another plus.
And something we love about that is that if you're working remote, or if you have a late flight,
you don't have to rush out to leave at 10 a.m. or 11 a.m. There's a late checkout, so checkout isn't till about 5 p.m., which is great, and it's rare to find that type of checkout on Airbnb as well. So if you're the type of person that likes to either have a slow morning, sleep in, or check out later in the day, this is a great spot for you to stay. Another thing is that Paul had all the like different toiletries, and there's labels everywhere that he left in the cabinets in the kitchen if you need anything, and you could even have fresh coffee in the morning. Thank you, Paul, you're awesome. So that's awesome. Like, it's such a nice place. As you can see, today is our last day. We're about to check out, but we haven't even left yet. I don't think Shaheen wants to leave. We keep going from indoors and outdoors, and he's staring outside like sad, like, are you okay?
Yeah.
You're gonna miss Paul,
of course.
Yeah, I'm gonna miss Paul and Carrie too. Oh, we love it here, guys. You won't regret it. Over 100 people have stood here in Paul's Airbnb here in Port Wentworth, Savannah, Georgia. And oh my God, such great reviews. And there's gonna be another great review because he does not disappoint. And he's just an awesome, authentic, such a kind and great person in general, and we are so grateful that we chose to stay here, guys. Of course, this is just us sharing this with you. No one, you know, asked us to, or no one's like, this isn't like a sponsored video or anything like that. We're just genuinely sharing this because we want you guys to have a great experience here and recommending to you guys a great place to stay. So it's definitely real. And these cats, oh my God, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I'm like in love with these cats right now. Look at them. They are so sweet.
This is Leis.
This is... No, that is...
Yeah.
Goof.
No.
That's Leis.
Oh, Leis. Yeah. Oh,
Leis. Sorry. You gotta say it with two syllables. Leis and Goof. Sweetest, most welcoming cats ever. They greeted us upon arrival. And it's been such a great stay. Truly, truly, truly highly recommend it. 10 out of 10. Anything you want to add?
Let's go. You got it.
We even left Paul a goodbye note before we left. So this is a thing he does. He had tons of these paper plates with notes from people that stood throughout the years. And I think it was a pretty neat idea. So we wanted to leave our note before we left. I've been trying to catch these hummingbirds, but they're so fast, man. Every time they show up, and we're like, there it is. Or Shaheen's like, there it is. It flies away. We feel like stalkers, man. Just watch. Hold the camera. And they're going to show up. There he is. Little guy flew away. But then we caught two more. Shaheen loves birds. I do too. There's something so peaceful out here. We're bracing it before we
my
head
drink.
Out.
The rest of my drink.
Oh,
into
that's
my container.
True. Like a to-go?
Yeah.
We're in the City Market area. Getting some treats before we head out. I'm so sad we have to go back home, but I do miss everyone. Anyways, it's only been 4 days. It went by fast. What do you think, babe? It went by fast, right?
It went by.
Yeah, I did. It went by super fast. Time goes fast when you're having fun, like they say. So this is
sick. Is this where we buy them?
Ooh, yeah, chocolate? Yeah, I haven't tried.
I'll try the original.
Thank you so much.
I'm an original kind of guy. Thank you.
It's so good. I'm not just saying that. Shaheen. Okay, I need to. How's that? Shaheen, how's your praline?
Mm-hmm.
Processing. I never had a chocolate praline before. It's so good. So another thing we do right before we leave Savannah is we stop by their candy shop here and we can't resist, but we have to go pick up some candies to bring back home. You want to try the chocolate one?
How is it?
So good.
I don't like the chocolate.
You don't like
it? I like this one.
What's wrong with him? No. Love you. So why don't we got? We can't get home to Chloe and Charlie and not bring them anything.
Again?
No. How are you gonna do that? It's a little tradition. You don't remember? We would get them the dog treats.
at the Wolfgang Bakery.
Oh, there you go.
They don't need nothing.
They're getting eggs every day.
Mom is spoiling them back home. We're getting pictures and videos of them and shit. Okay, so we just got here at Wolfgang Bakery. It's here in the city market, so we have to do it. We do it when we're back home and we go to visit Sarasota. So we're gonna do it here in Savannah too. I gotta bring them something. Look at this, this is so cute. Oh, I miss Chloe and Charlie, guys. Is that the cutest pet shop for like pet treats, goodies, pet souvenirs, leashes, all that good stuff. Donuts, a donut board for dogs? Shaheen, my heart, and it smells so good. If you know something about me, I love donuts. And if my dogs can have one too, that's a plus. This is so cute. And of course, some light souvenir shopping before we head back. Okay? What are you looking for, babe?
Nothing, just looking.
Just looking? Me too. Just looking. Alright, we see hats, Savannah hats. I feel like we've brought home some stuff here or from here already. But you know, when the peach cobbler was so good you had to return. But this time, what was it that you got?
Banana pudding.
Yeah, this time you got banana pudding, so we're gonna try that in a minute. No one knows. No one understands why. Look, you gotta face reality, okay? You gotta head back home. It's just what it is, okay? All right, Shaheen Miller. Oh, is he really gonna open the door for me? Oh my goodness. Oh my god, I must feel like a queen. Psych.
Oh,
thank you, sir. Wow.
Paid enough for this.
Wow. Pay, please. Treat me right, that's right. Oh my goodness, look at this. Are you gonna finally try that?
Alright, let's take it out.
Whoa. No, I'm sorry, but. Okay, I gotta say this, babe. Okay, you good?
See, they did give me a.
Okay, that is the banana pudding, right? And that looks better than the one from Sweet Potatoes. I'm sorry.
It does.
For this year, this time around.
It does.
They came through. Can we open it? Yeah, I'll help you with that.
You want to help? Open it.
I'm helping
you,
open it.
Oh, okay.
I'm not going to try. I'm too full.
Oh, you want to help?
And I just had a chocolate praline, boy.
Mm-hmm. Right. She's not going to try it, guys, right? Mm-hmm.
He's going to force me to try it and then say that I want
to. Oh, I'm going to. Guys, look. I'm going to force her to try it. Yeah.
Hold on. Let me get a picture.
This looks good.
As always, stay well.
Be blessed.
And continue to live the fine life. Take care, everyone.